Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. You want your scoped enums, right? You know, enum, class, whatever. Yes, I know it can be slightly troublesome with those and model view. We'll discuss why, and especially I'll show you a solution to that problem in this very episode. So stay tuned. Let me show you some code that explains why this is slightly troublesome. Subclass QAbstractTableModel, you've seen that a couple of times already in Qt Widgets and More. In here, I have an enum class column with name, age, and column count. These are my column that I have in my table. I like to name them because then it's easier in my CPP file to see what's going on. You can see over here in my header data, for example, that is where I need to answer those things. So for example, I need to tell it that it's name when it's a name column. But see, the problem is that the section here, which I'm switching over, is an integer. And my column, colon, colon, name is in enum class. So what do I do about that? Well, one solution is to simply say static cast column. So I take my section, I cast it into a column. I cross my fingers that I did remember to have all my columns, which is very, very likely that I did, because if you go down here and look at my column count, that one is returning the column count. And if you go back up here, you can even see that I go for all of them. And given that I switch over an enum, if I add another column at some point, it will complain. But still, slightly annoying that I have to static cast column in here. I have the same problem in my data method. Remember, my data method is the one that returns the data for the given cell, but it could also return the font or the color or the tooltip or one of my own things. So it also, namely the role, comes in as an integer. You can see that right here. This time I cannot do the same thing of just saying switch and then cast role, because what enum would I cast it to? I could cast it to qt colon colon, I cannot even remember, item data role. But remember, we can also ask for our own role, so it could be outside of that one. So instead, I need to do like what you see here, case static cast int to this display role. Slightly annoying to write that for each and every place. And as you might see up here, I could also just write plus. We use this little trick in KDAB viewer, which is my tool in KDAB that I'm working on. And every single time somebody new comes in, they will right away ask, what is that unary plus doing there? It's not even an integer that's on the right side. And you're entirely right. It is not the most readable thing, but it's very, very useful. Let me show you the implementation of that little plus. So the implementation of this little plus is what you see on line 28 to 32. Let me just walk you through the code here. First of all, it's a template on something E, that's actually the enum here. And it's implementing a lot of stuff here. It's implementing operator plus. I'm pretty sure you've overwritten operator plus for the binary case where two complex numbers or whatever that you concatenate together. But there's also the unary plus. That's the one that we are overloading here. It takes this enum in as a parameter here. And what it simply does is that it does a static cast of that enum here. And first of all, it does a static cast to the type that is the underlying type of that enum. So you might even not even know, but enum class, you could write enum class foo colon short, telling that underneath your short, your enum should be represented using a short instead of spending a complete integer for that enum. If you do not specify, that's what I was trying to say, the colon short, it's just fine. But that's what it says here, cast to that underlying type. And that's, by the way, also the return type, this whole thing of our operator plus. And let me just go to the header file again here, to the implementation file. And you can see down here the beauty of it, case plus role colon name. role colon colon name, that is actually an enum that I have here myself, enum class role, name, Qt user role, and birthday. And I also have a case Qt colon colon display role. Of course, display role is also an enum, but it's not an enum class, so there I do not need this trick. So that was the easy part of that larger file. There was also a much bigger chunk implementing something called enumcast. Let's have a look at what that does now. So first of all, from a user's point of view, you can see that my static cast here now turned into an enumcast, and again column. So, well, hash mark defines static cast, enumcast, that's not really saving all that much. But as you can see from the code over here, there is just a wee little bit more to it. I'm not going to go into bother you with all the details of this stuff here, but what this basically does is that it adds a temporized variable called hasColumnCount, and here is another one, hasRowCount. And then my enumCast, you can see there is this if const cast hasColumnCount of the type that I give in, then I will assert that my value is actually larger than zero and less than, and here's the plus again, type of column count. Okay, I admit, this is not rocket science. I'm not showing you something that will change your world, but it's an assert, and the more assert you can get in your code, the better. It asserts that whenever I try to cast to that enum, that is actually what I cast from, the integer that I'm trying to cast to that enum, actually is within range of that enum. And let's go back and look at the code now. So what you'll notice in this code is that it tests whether there is a column count, and then it uses the column count. Or is there a row count, it uses that. Or if there's a max count. So the enums that are to be used with this enum cast need to be one of those. And well, it'll give me a compile error if I try to use it without one of those. Column count and row count, I always use exactly that name for my columns and rows that you see here in my model. My model here, role is column has column count. And did I have something where I would have I would name my rows and I would have a row count at the end. And with that enumcast section, if I somehow get section wrong in here and it's outside of that enum, I will get an assert, hey, you tried to cast to an enum and that is not possible. Very nice little safety net underneath these casts. Okay, I haven't even shown you what the application is all about, and it's really not that interesting. It's a table that looks onto a model. But I'll nevertheless, and I have shown you this before, but just in case that you forgot about this little trick, how do you communicate from the model to somewhere else? Remember, every time we have this set up, model down here, table up here, think stuck, a bunch of proxy models in between that you need to navigate through. I'll give you a link underneath this video here to another video I did on exactly that. If you haven't seen that, you must go and see that now. Otherwise, well, not now. Stay tuned, see it afterwards. Okay, running the application now. As you can see, it's a bunch of elderly gentlemen's name. You might have guessed by now it's a members, either current or past members of Depeche Mode. I love them very much. And if I click on Martin Lee Gore here, double click on him, I can see that there's 100 days to Martin's birthday. What you'll notice, however, is that it doesn't say 100 anywhere here. So there is this back channel of communication from the view to the model asking this information. And it does so using this role over here, enum class role. I can ask for the name, I can ask for the birthday. The name, I could go and look that up in column name up here. And that's why also you can see it's good to have the class here, because I actually do have the same name twice, same name twice. Anyway, I'm getting behind my, what I have here is birthday as a role over in here in my data. If you're asking for the role birthday, this enum here, then return, I looked up the data from my data structure, and my data structure is pretty simple. I just hard coded it in my model. But nevertheless, I look up my data So I have my row here, and my row.birthday is what I'll be looking up. So if I ask for the birthday, I will give that back. And looking here over in my header, birthday is a Qt date. My view, if I even have that running still, I don't, I can get that really fast. My view only shows the age of the gentleman here. So the view shows, as you can see in column H, it does some magic figuring out, did we have birthday this year or not? And then depending on that answer, returns the number. But I can still go and ask the model for the birthday using this birthday role. And now my table over here, what it does is that whenever I double click on a cell, it calls this slot here, it does ask her for a bunch of different things. Among other things, it goes to the index and say, can you please give me the data for this this role called birthday? And observe the small plus sign again here. That is that unary plus that takes this role, which is an enum class, converts it into an integer, because that's exactly what my data method expects. Now I convert that thing that I got back, which I got back as a QVariant. I convert that into a date, and here is my birthday, and here is my message box for bringing up that information. That's it for this episode of Qt Widgets and More. I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. Thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting us. Well, your thumbs up, that is supporting me. It makes me feel good. So do give me a thumb up. It will help my ego.